afternoon, friends. Welcome back to another edition of Mighty Kids Yoga. My name is Miss Susie, and of course, these are my amazing yoga helpers, Gigi Thompson, Reagan Mead, and Addison Weinman. And today, we are going to be showing you some simple, easy poses that you can do right from the comfort of your own home. So please join us. And it's always important to meet your body where it is for that day. So make sure that you're comfortable and your body is ready to be stretched out. And we're gonna start with some easy breaths. So you're gonna start on the floor, sitting crisscross applesauce, or as we call it in yoga, easy pose. You're gonna put your hands on your knees. And we're gonna breathe in through our belly. We're gonna take some deep belly breaths in through our nose and out through our mouths to get started. Ready? Right, and when you've done your breaths for your 15 seconds, you're gonna come up, you're gonna sit in staff pose. You're gonna sit on the floor with your legs together out in front of you, and you're gonna keep your back and your spine nice and straight, and relax your shoulders away from your ear. You're just gonna stand, you should be able to feel the stretch in your calves and in your hamstrings. From sitting as still as a statue, you should also be able to feel a little bit of pull in your back, especially if your posture is not always so good. From staff pose, we're gonna go into river pose. And without rounding your back, you're gonna bend forward from your hips, reach your hands out to your feet, and hold your toes if you can. If you can't, that's okay. Reach as far out as you possibly can. And put your shins, or put your elbows on your shins if you can do that, if that's comfortable for you. You're gonna hold this for 5 long breaths. So let's breathe. Again, we're going to go into a seated forward fold pose. So you're going to bend again from the hips, and you're going to reach your hands towards your feet. And with each exhale, try to stretch a little bit further to see if you can get your head to touch your yoga mat between your legs. Okay, if you're not able to do that, that's okay. Go as far as your body will let you. Are we ready? Let's try it. And 5 deep breaths. And good. The next pose we're going to move into is called the bird dog pose. So what that means is we're gonna actually get up on our knees, our hands and knees, into something called the tabletop pose. So you're gonna look like a little table. You're slowly gonna raise one arm off your mat, and whichever arm you raise, you're gonna raise the opposite leg off the mat. You're gonna try and keep your arm in line with your shoulder. Don't put any extra stress on your shoulder. And you're gonna hold this for 5 breaths, and then we're gonna switch sides and do it on the other side. And switch. And switch back to the other side. And switch. And down. Good job. From bird dog pose, we're gonna slowly rise to our knees. We're gonna bring one leg out in front of us, making sure that the knee of our front leg stays directly over our ankles. And then we're gonna raise our head and our palms and our arms toward the sky. Now, if it's not comfortable for you to have your hands together, you can put them apart. And of course, if we do it on one side, we have to do it on the other side. So go ahead and come down and switch legs. Now, if you bend a little further in, you'll feel a little bit more of a lunge, feel a little bit more of a bird. And switch again. All right. Next, we're going to come to standing in mountain pose. Mountain pose is just standing up straight and tall with our palms open next to our sides. From there, from mountain pose, we're going to take a big step back with one foot onto the ball of our foot. We're going to bend our front leg until our knee is lined up with our ankle. And keeping our torso straight and even, we are going to bend down to try and put our hands as close as we can to on the mat or on the mat. And stretch it forward, girls. Every time you breathe out, stretch a little bit further. We'll do it for 5 breaths and then we'll switch legs. Switch. So remember to take a big step back, bend your foot over your ankle, put your arms above, and bend your body forward. Now, some of you might be more flexible on one side than the other, so when you switch legs, you might be able to reach the floor a little easier. We're going to do this for 5 breaths. And switch sides. And when you're comfortable, fold forward. Count for 5 breaths. And up. And the other leg. Switch again. Over your heads and fold forward. to go into is the half dancer pose. You're gonna bend your right knee to bring your foot to your bottom and hold it with your hands. So let's start little. Bend your knee and try and hold your foot. Okay, so from that pose, try put your opposite arm out in front of you, bend forward and try as your foot goes out behind you to keep a hold on it for the half dancer. Oh, you got it, good job. Good job, this is a hard one. There, you got it. All right, girls, let's try it on the other side now. So we're gonna do the same thing with our left foot. Grab it at your tushy and lean back. If you're not able to do that, you can also just put your leg out behind you, balancing on one leg. What do you think I'm gonna say? Switch legs, that's right. So for all our friends at home, switch your legs. And switch again. All right. And come back to mountain pose. The next pose that we're gonna do is called the ragdoll's pose. So from mountain pose, you're gonna lift your arms above your head, and you're gonna hug yourself in the air, and then we're gonna bend as far as we can forward at the waist, and we're just gonna hang like a ragdoll for 5 deep breaths. And back to mountain pose. Now from mountain pose, we're gonna go into Miss Susie's favorite yoga pose of all, which is tree pose. And of course, in tree pose, there are 3 ways that you can do this for your comfort level. You can do it where you gently rest your heel on your opposite ankle. You can do it where your foot is resting inside your knee pit, but not putting strain on the knee. Or if you're able to, you can go higher and put your foot all the way in your thigh, as long as you're able to stand comfortably and not fall over. This is a good meditative place to stay for a few breaths. And after we've bent our tree on one side, girls, what are we gonna do?
On the other side.
We're gonna be a tree on the other side as well. It's very comforting to be a tree. All right, so now we're going to go back into mountain pose. We're gonna push our legs a little bit further apart. You can even change your position on the mat if you'd rather go this way, so you can get your legs nice and far apart. We're gonna do something called the swaying tree pose. So our arms are gonna go up over our heads, interlocked with our fingers, and we're gonna go to the right first. So we're gonna go to the right, to the center, to the left, in almost an aerobic motion. And we're gonna do that 10 times together while we breathe. And remember to stop in the center on your way to the right or the left. And this is called the swaying tree pose. So picture yourself as a swaying willow in the middle of a summer's day. Nice cool breeze coming off the lake. Or if you prefer, imagine yourself a tree in the middle of winter. back into mountain pose, and from mountain pose, you're going to be able to go back into child's pose. So you're going to sit in child's pose for a minute, 3 deep breaths, and then we're going to lay on our backs and start to go into relaxation pose. All right, girls, go ahead and lay down in relaxation pose. You're going to lay right on your backs with your arms at your sides, palms up or down, your choice. You can pull your legs apart if you want, or just let them fall gently. You're going to gently close your eyes, relax, and allow your whole body to sink into the support of the floor below you. Relax your tongue, your eyebrows, your eyes, your jaw, your mind. Think about something that brings you joy. Maybe it's ice cream. Maybe it's riding your bike because the weather is finally nice. And so for our friends watching at home, you can sit or lay in relaxation mode for as long as you need to. Forever, for as long as it feels right. Not forever, but slip of the tongue there. When you feel like you've relaxed enough, you're going to slowly start to wiggle your toes and fingers. Slowly start to wiggle your legs and your arms. And then when you're feeling confident, you can come back up to easy pose. Thank you guys so much for joining us for the April edition of Mighty Kids Yoga. We'll be back next month with a special announcement.